I was completely unaware of these dumb little wars that FFMPEG got into with random downstream projects. There seems to be this semi-reoccurring trend where usually a company builds a media tool on top of FFMPEG, which is totally fine, the license lets you do that. But then they'll talk about how much better their tool is than using just regular old FFMPEG, but then you look underneath and it's literally just a wrapper for FFMPEG. Yeah, maybe they provide some different infrastructure and stuff like that, but at its core, it's relying on the project. Now, for anyone who doesn't know, this project is a very popular, very powerful media toolkit used in projects like Blender, DaVinci Resolve, Handbrake, Plex, VLC, YouTube uses it on the back end, Google Chrome, and it's even used on Mars to compress audio and video in the Perseverance rover. And if you're curious about random other things that use it, the project has a big long list of other things that depend on it. These are things that they know about. There's almost certainly going to be other things. And you know what else uses it? A company and software called Bitmovin. Bitmovin empowers businesses to expand their viewer reach and stream video globally with unmatched reliability, scalability, and the highest quality across the broadest range of devices. And back in February of 2024, FFMPEG shared this post made by the CEO of Bitmovin. Forget hosting FFMPEG in your cloud, use the Bitmovin encoding in your cloud account, most advanced features, scalability layer, and save compute, egress, storage, and CDN. It's a no-brainer. Wouldn't it be great if companies which sold FFMPEG as a service wouldn't then attack FFMPEG on LinkedIn? Because yes, Bitmovin is also a wrapper around FFMPEG. Basically, what is being said here is don't host FFMPEG in your cloud. Instead, host this wrapper of FFMPEG in your cloud instead. It's so much better. And look, maybe it provides some additional tooling on top that actually is a lot better, but you're still using FFMPEG at your core. Like, this seems like a real weird thing to do, to go and attack someone who's not even your direct competition. They are the thing you rely on. So FFMPEG reached out to the CEO with this. Hi Stefan, seeing as it's FFMPEG running inside Bitmovin, perhaps this isn't a smart thing to write. Don't get me wrong, FFMPEG is an amazing piece of software, but there is a lot of effort in scaling operating system software in the cloud, i.e. using spot instances efficiently via a split and stitch approach, doing distributed rate control, MOLLE 3 pass encoding, per title, per shot chunk, etc. These areas are just a lot of work for media companies and often result in huge costs. And again, that all might be great, but you're still selling a wrapper to FFMPEG, so why take a shot at FFMPEG? And for someone who feels like the post was totally fine, he very shortly went and deleted it. Like, let's put this in another context, right? Imagine if GitHub or GitLab started just taking shots at Git, right? Like, it's one thing to take a shot at GitLab, or take a shot at GitHub, or take a shot at Giddy or Forgia or anything like that, which are all like direct competition to the thing you're providing, but why take a shot at your dependency? And after the fact, the CEO reached out on Twitter. I'm sorry that this escalated, and if I came across as disrespectful to FFMPEG, that was not my intention. I'm a big fan of what you guys do, and in fact, Bitmovin started out as open source too, with libdash and other open source libraries. I'd be happy to have a chat offline to discuss if there's something I can do to clarify things further. If that will help, I'll drop you a DM. And then he realized that Twitter DMs are absolute garbage right now, and yeah, it's this platform is useless for private communication. But why am I talking about something that happened over a year ago? Well, it seems like Bitmovin wants to make this a yearly tradition. You could do it once and just be done, or you do the same thing again. This time not from the CEO, but instead the general manager. This right here is just marketing nonsense, don't really care about that. Let's go to the second paragraph. Read more below about how the Bitmovin VOD encoder outperformed the previous FFmpeg-based in-house solution, enabling SOEG to deliver superior video streaming quality in a cost-efficient and audience-tailored way, and this is just thanks to random people. Looks like Bitmovin are at it again, using FFmpeg internally and criticizing FFmpeg in their sales pitches. They didn't learn from last time. Basically, what is being said here... so stupid. What they're saying here is their new FFmpeg-based encoder is faster than their previous FFmpeg-based encoder. They're still using FFmpeg. It's still just FFmpeg. Like, what are you doing? And as it stands, this post has not been deleted, so I'm going to show you some of the comments because they're just as fun. Hi, Eric. Is it really a good idea to tag FFmpeg as being inferior to your solution in your post when Bitmovin is using FFmpeg internally? Hi, FFmpeg. Everything I wrote above is factual, so I'm not sure what you mean by good idea. The FFmpeg tag was unnecessary. I removed it. This is about the customer deciding between a make or buy and picking the encoding solution that best fulfills business requirements. It certainly was not meant in a disrespectful way to the FFmpeg open source products and community. I absolutely love LinkedIn because LinkedIn is basically just Facebook, but everyone has a professional headshot. People say things that are just as dumb as Facebook. No difference. The only difference is the things they're talking about. On Facebook, it's gonna be like conspiracy theories and minions. On LinkedIn, it's gonna be some wild business take. It's gonna be taking shots at everyone. It's fun. I love it. Would Bitmovin explicitly mention a move from Mux or Brightcove or Dolby.io? Obviously not. No other video platform repeatedly writes about FFmpeg in such a demeaning way. This demonstrates a lack of respect from Bitmovin for the open source technologies that underpin their business and would make their business model unviable without. Bear in mind, it was Eric Thomas who initially tagged us in his announcement. Otherwise, this would have just been another piece of SEO spam mentioning FFmpeg. We would recommend all users choose a platform that doesn't degrade FFmpeg in its marketing materials while depending on FFmpeg internally and contributing nothing back. They could have easily written an in-house solution in the article and moved on with their lives. But it's clear they want to market themselves as an alternative to FFmpeg, tagging us explicitly on LinkedIn and mentioning FFmpeg several times in the case study while using FFmpeg internally and contributing nothing back. No other video platform uses FFmpeg in its marketing in such a demeaning fashion, nor would they highlight any other such video platform as being inferior, Mux, Brightcove, etc. Ending the thread with a comment from the CEO. FFmpeg. I'm sorry about the wording and the picture you got. We are going to change the case study according to your suggestions. As mentioned before, we are big supporters of open source projects. We started Bitmovin based on open source tools to encode MPEG Dash as well as a reference library, and we continue to open source a bunch of our tooling up to today. We also financially support open source projects like X264, X265, AOM, and also FFmpeg. We sponsored the FFmpeg booth and hotel rooms at the IBC show in Amsterdam in September, so please accept our apologies. What's your bet this is going to happen at the same time next year? I'm taking bets now. I think there is a high possibility somewhere around February, we're going to see the exact same thing done once again. Now, going back to Twitter, FFmpeg got into an argument with an ex-employee of Bitmovin. No one is shitting on FFmpeg, seriously. The point is, for some, it's better to use tools like Bitmovin to manage workflows. No one in their right mind is suggesting FFmpeg is shit. Since my post is the one that started this whole shitstorm last year, I thought I'd clarify. And basically, they have the exact same argument that was had over on LinkedIn, but also linking to this post right here. This has been going on for a while. Corporate types will shield their own or others' product and shit on the open source backends they rely on. This happened at the last company I worked with. They suggested some cloud-based SaaS service that's better than FFmpeg. I think it was AWS Media Convert. Pulled the sheets back, and it's just FFmpeg. And having that all nicely set up for you so you don't have to deal with setting up FFmpeg yourself, maybe getting a nice GUI to deal with it, all that stuff is great. All that stuff is additional value, but it's additional value in the way that GitHub or GitLab or Giddy, things like that, are additional value on top of Git. But they also don't go out of their way to say, well, don't go and use Git. Use GitHub. Don't go and use Git. Use Giddy. Because those tools wouldn't exist if Git never existed. And Bitmovin and all of these other wrappers around FFmpeg probably wouldn't exist if FFmpeg didn't exist and wasn't as good as it is. But what do you think? Ignore the change in lighting. I definitely didn't forget to record this. Also, it does look a little bit better. Maybe I need to like adjust my camera settings with the window being open now. I don't know. I'll play around with some stuff. Anyway, if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out my Patreon, Scribes, Libera Pay, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and F. F's in chat.